Grey's Anatomy, Monday.
Until Wednesday at Target, get 20% off clothing, 20% off sleepwear, and 20% off footwear. Excludes underwear, socks, and hosiery.
South Australia has the best workplace relations record in Australia and the most jobs in our history. Our way works. Canberra's new work laws would put all that at risk. It's simply not fair for you or your kids to have to negotiate with the boss alone about pay cuts or public holidays or meal breaks. The South Australian Government wants your choices at work to be real choices, not give in or get out. To let Canberra know what you think, visit our website. A message from the Government of South Australia, authorised by the State Government, Adelaide.
Why did Dove ask six women with curvy thighs, rounder hips, and pear-shaped bums to try their new firming range? Well, testing it on size 8 supermodels wouldn't be much of a challenge, would it?
The big small thing.
New Dove Intensive Cellulite Gel Cream, firming lotion, and firming body wash. New Dove Firming, as tested on real curves.
AAPT's $49 home chat deal lets you make local, national and international calls from your home phone, plus calls to any mobile, anywhere, with $120 worth of calls for $49 a month. AAPT, call 133140.
Chance to make their dreams come true. It all comes down to what they say next.
Can I just take a minute?
You're going to get rich or burnt when you enter the Dragon's Den Monday on 7.
I mean, could we sell today for, say, 580 or 600?
No chance. Absolutely no chance. I can tell you right now.
In Brisbane, Amanda Higgins' auction isn't going well.
All right, it's 650.
I'll countersign at 650.
650. We can do that.
We'll do that now.
Yeah, we can.
We'll have a chat. Otherwise, we'll have to
touch it. No problem. Okay.
Pity we didn't hear that gavel going down.
The auctioneer's feeling the heat. He's got to produce another 100 grand out of nowhere.
So we're at $550,000. You are the highest bidder. We are under instructions at this stage. Just can't quite sell for that amount of money.
575.
Dormy tries to sweat a bit more out of Bill.
Bid 560.
Yeah. 560.
560 now.
If he changes the front figure to a 6,
no worries.
Amanda's not impressed.
At $560,000, bids there at that. First time of call, 560.
Hello. Bid. We're 90,000 short of what it cost.
Second time of call, 560,000. Any further rise in advancement on that? Final call, any further bids at all? So you are the highest approved bidder. You do have that first right of refusal. Thank you very much for your attendance here this afternoon, and I do trust you'll have a good weekend. Thank you.
Oh, there's not much to clap about there, folks. And Richard the auctioneer has to go inside to face the music with no sale.
What was it that Malcolm Fraser once
said? Can I just have a go with that gavel?
Life wasn't meant to be easy.
No, I don't want to shake your hand.
No, you're going to shake my hand for doing a good auction. Unfortunately,
You just made my flab wobble.
But unfortunately, we're too far away. Now, here you go,
Amanda. You shook it that much, it made my flab wobble. Give me that diary. Bang.
The gavel may have fallen, but Amanda's mortgage hasn't.
Lots of debt. Lots and lots of debt.
Definitely think the house is worth a bit more, but there's too many here sitting for that price, not selling. Then you've got to put yourself at the other end if you want to resell.
Work harder. Work, work, work. Pay that mortgage.
2 weeks later, Bill Kirsten upped his offer to $600,000, and Amanda accepted. She took a $50,000 bath on that house. And the lesson? Well, check out our website at domain.com.au, where you'll find tips on how to renovate with resale in mind. Very important information. Now let's head back to Sunnybank Hills, where Renee Hunscheid is right in the thick of Operation Tree Transplant.
Hello, he's smiling. Looks like the transplant is starting to work.
Yay!
He deserved a win, but Caroline's still being driven crazy by her husband's wasteful ways.
Renee, are you going to save those pavers?
No, they're not Balinese.
Oh, God. But they cost money.
Only a little bit of money, they were seconds.
What tragic waste.
Oh, boy.
They spent a few thousand dollars building that wall just a couple of years ago.
Oh, I can feel an earthquake.
Renee, do you want me to grab those lights?
If you want to grab them out, doesn't matter.
But a rescue mission.
No, don't worry about it. I don't like them anymore. I'm using those other little stainless steel ones.
More waste.
Uh-oh. What's this?
What is that for? Power?
That's the power to the underside garage.
Oh, okay.
Well, we can kiss the power to the underground garage goodbye. We'll have to do the door by manual now. We are running over budget already. The excavator was here longer than we expected. I was given a quote of around about $5,000. We're blown out to $7,500.
10 days later, and the Hunscheids have well into phase two, the bricklaying.
Yeah, Paul, how many more do you think you need for this wall?
Renee's right in the thick of it.
About another 140? Okay, I'll keep going.
The view from the top is spectacular. But I wonder, how's the bottom line looking?
Carolyn thinks the budget's blowing out a little bit, but at this stage, we're not worried, too concerned about it. It's about maybe 15, 20,000 already over.
15 to 20 over? That puts it at around the 40,000 mark, double Renee's original estimate.
But we'll worry about that towards the end.
And despite the budget going into orbit, he's considering yet another expensive add-on.
Renee's thinking of getting the best block wall rendered inside the garage, which I think's a bit pointless, but our cars will be happy.
Still to come.
Kitchen, meals and living.
Imagining a better future.
We've been saying in the marketing that this is sort of the worst house in the best street.
I love it.
On Today Tonight, the DPP drops the charges over Liddy's hidden guns.
Nothing ceases to amaze me.
The case no one seemed to want. 4 prosecutors in 4 months.
One of them, in fact, failed to turn up.
And Liddy's lawyer friend allowed to walk away.
You end up being a law unto yourself, your office.
As victims lose again, Monday.
The 7 News Today Tonight $40,000 grocery checkout. It's Adelaide's biggest grocery giveaway. Just watch 7 News and Today Tonight for the daily keyword. Then listen to Mix 102.3 weekdays for the clues to call. It's all thanks to Coca-Cola, Mix 102.3 and Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
You'll never know. Her family has just been evicted. You'll never know how much your gift means. That's why it means so much. Find the true meaning of Christmas and place your gift under the Kmart wishing tree.
Big day, Brendan.
Big day, all right. Soccer first. You got nothing, Bex. Then a bush bash with Mike. And then surfing with Sophie Hopkins. But first, breakfast. Need the energy to get through all that. Milo cereal. The goodness from wheat and slow-burning energy. And of course, the great taste of Milo. Now with Milo foot bags to collect, I'll need all the slow-burning energy I can get.
There's 4 Milo foot bags to collect, free in special packs of Milo cereal.
Why are there no clouds in the sky?
Because God wants to watch his favourite band again.
Green Day's awesome live CD-DVD set, Bullet in a Bible. It's a religious experience.
There goes gravity, oh, there goes rabbit, he choke. He's so mad, but he won't give up, daddies, he know he won't have it. But the beat goes on, da-da-dum, da-dum. Lose yourself in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, you better lose yourself.
The goodies are heading down under for a national tour, starring Tim Brooke Taylor, Graham Garden, and a special non-appearance by Bill Oddie from London. The goodies, still alive on stage. Tickets on sale now.
Hey, Ernie, those new uniforms you ordered have arrived.
Great.
We'll change anything, but the taste.
Get in now for Toyota's 2005 Countdown. The RACV's most affordable medium car to run and own. The four-cylinder Camry Altis Limited Auto is now just $26,988 drive away.
Quarantine is everywhere, protecting this amazing wildlife sanctuary, Australia. Airports, cruise ship terminals, or however you travel. Quarantine matters.
Authorised by the Australian Government, Canberra.
It's the Great Outdoors Ultimate Travel Guide to the best of the USA.
You guys do not want to miss it.
It's the places you've always wanted to experience.
And the adventures you never knew existed.
The Great Outdoors Ultimate USA Special, Monday.
Welcome back. Now, as we've already seen tonight, real estate doesn't always turn to gold. Well, our next story is about a house in the Victorian Bayside city of Geelong. And it's very much a case of the worst house in the best street, which might just give it an edge on auction day. From the outside, your first impression is of a pretty tired old weatherboard. Hasn't been painted for years. But the renovators amongst us will already be stripping back the paint and seeing the gem that lies beneath, this diamond in the rough. Pressed metal gables, picture rails lurking under the cracked plaster, original fireplaces. It's all there, just waiting to be nurtured.
We all know it needs a huge amount of work. It needs more than a paintbrush and a hammer. But everyone can see that. As someone said to me, it's an honest, straight house.
And it's on a lovely big block of land. 475 square metres. And there's rear lane access. And there's also a lot of scope for improvement.
It's a lovely area, this part of East Geelong. I mean, Meyer Street in particular is a lovely wide street, as you've seen with the trees. We've been saying in the marketing that this is sort of the worst house in the best street.
Looks good to me. And Geelong is attracting a lot of attention these days as Victoria's largest provincial city. It's got a manufacturing base, and the old port has recently been given a multi-million dollar makeover, making it a mecca for families.
I think it's attracted a lot of interest because of the location.
Busy working mum Sally Ward thinks she could transform the Geelong gem into the perfect family home.
I think this will be Ben's room. This will be great for Ben. I love it.
Ben is Sally's 11-year-old son. Both are tennis mad, and Sally's the first to admit it. She knows more about backhands than building.
I'm not that handy as such, but I would certainly be able to make sure that the renovations do take place under my watchful eye.
Kitchen, meals and living.
Yeah, we'll knock out this bit and bring it back as well in line.
And deck in the middle.
Better watch out, Sally. Here's the competition, and these blokes really know their business.
The rest of it. We've got our own building company, and we'd like to buy up some of the old houses and keep their features instead of knocking them down.
They might look like brothers, but Keith and Brad Fry are a father and son team.
We've worked together now for 12 years. We're putting through an apprenticeship.
There's nothing these two love more than a challenge, which explains their interest in the Geelong gem.
Yeah, well, a bit of new plaster and a bit of paint will come up fantastic.
There'd be quite a lot of work. It has been re-stumped already, which is a good start. But yeah, look, it needs to fully rewire. Everything needs to be done pretty much, plus the whatever extension gets put out the back, pull take the back off it, I suppose.
How much are they prepared to spend at auction? Well, the boys aren't saying, but Sally's open to speculation.
I would say it'll be in the vicinity of the 200,000s.
up in the Blue Mountains, the Mad Hatter's rain dance has just waltzed into day two.
And it's flat enough, is it?
Well, yeah. Let's put a dumpy on it when we get the first ring on.
Mark's put his pipe drummer on hold while he takes delivery of the big water tank. Fully installed, it's costing him a bit over $6,000. But get this, it can hold up to 45,000 litres. Beautiful.
22-year warranty, and if you have any problems, give us a yell.
Now, it doesn't take long for the Hatter to sort out this end of the pipe.
Theoretically, that end of it's ready to go.
But his real dramas are at the other end. He simply hasn't got enough pipe.
I said, you haven't got any 40mm pipe in stock either. Yeah, tow.
And the bad news is, the plumbing shop has a supply problem.
There's no way you can cut a 100-metre roll in half, is there?
If he wants to finish the job today, Mark's going to have to take a thinner pipe.
Yeah, look, if you could change it all to 32 and bring the appropriate fittings and, you know, race up here like Wayne Gardner, eh? Yeah, good-o. I'll see you soon, Wayne. Come on, you want to give us a hand instead?
How do you like that? And the fastest delivery guy in the West has arrived with not only the missing leg, the pipe, but the small water tank as well. The right one this time.
What's the go on this? Get it onto the ground. I'm about 5 hours late. The tank's just been arrived. The pipe's just been delivered. The clouds are getting really quite black. Man, I'm going to have to get flying. Seriously. Now, not too much laughing, because I don't know if this is going to work or not, but...
Whoever said the humble wheelbarrow can't also double as a pack horse?
Now, the theory says I get that and I go... Hi-ya!
You've got to hand it to the Hatter. He's a can-do kind of guy.
Whoa.
If only he could see where he's going.
Yep, can't see a bloody thing. Looking good, baby. Hallelujah. Snake wrestling time again. Let's go.
Now, back to that pipe again.
What's happened with the pipe supply? I couldn't get you more of this 50 mil. So I've dropped down to a 32 millimetre pipe, which is not a problem, yeah? Just means I've got to put a couple of extra fittings in to reduce it down in size. Like, as easy as that. Or maybe if you get it and you, pounding it in. That works.
Right. Well, I'm glad that's done. All that's left now is to test out the new system and hope like hell the water goes where it's meant to go.
I'm still hopeful I can start pumping some water up here tonight, right? But I'm not going to put that in writing.
Ahead on Hot Property...
This is your renovator's delight.
The Geelong Gem goes to auction.
Round me off at 200.
Yes. AD, happy to sell now?
Oh, yes, thanks. Okay.
Good evening. A police commissioner's inquiry will follow today's shootout at Burnside. A 29-year-old man is in hospital after being shot when he opened fire on police who had been called to the Kings Avenue residence. Good news and bad news at the airport. 90 new jobs as Jetstar sets up a base here, but the new airport terminal appears no closer to opening. Port Lincoln was awash with Viva Fever today as the locals paid tribute to favourite son Tony Santic and his triple Melbourne Cup winner Mackay Diva. The weather hot and 31 tomorrow ahead of a possible evening shower.
Ada won, but it's not over yet, because Tom Williams is back. Can he wipe her clean off the dance floor? Tuesday, it's week one of the Tom vs. Ada Ultimate Dance-Off. Dancing with the Stars, the champion of champions dance-off at the special time. Tuesday, 8:30, after the premiere of Headland.
The new special edition Holden SSZ ute with $6,000 of extras, including new 18-inch alloys, premium brakes, leather seats and a hard tonneau. It's very hot.
Working long hours wearing contact lenses can be tough on my eyes. My friend recommended One Day AccuView, the world's number one selling daily disposables. Daily disposables are the healthiest for my eyes. For fresh, comfortable lenses every day. One Day AccuView, a fresh new start every day.
Download the latest tracks straight to your 3 mobile now.
In his own backyard or yours, this person makes a choice every day.
Here he comes.
The choice to make a difference. South Australian Police Recruiting Centre now.
Sunsilk 200ml shampoo or conditioner, $2. Rexona roll-ons, $2. 3kg Omo, not 3,000 dong, just $6.99. 150ml Cousins Morning Fresh dishwashing liquid, $1.50. Pack of four, 125g Imperial Leather Soap, $2. 100g Colgate with toothbrush, 99 cents. Pack of six, 3-ply toilet tissues, just $2. 1.5 horsepower split, $3.99.
We're in the hunt for Cybertops hiding inside Kinder Surprise.
Wow. 12 to collect with magic codes for online adventures. Start hunting for Cybertops inside Kinder Surprise before they disappear back into cyberspace forever.
Next, you'll find out if this is ABBA's all-time greatest hit as we count them down. ABBA's all-time greatest hits is next.
It's auction day for the Geelong Gem. And agent David Barnett is brimming with confidence.
I've got no doubt that that it will sell today for a very good figure.
But to whom?
A bit of an extension on the back of it, make it bigger.
Well, there's Keith and Brad, our father and son building team.
Nice to do an old one again. We haven't done an old one for quite a while.
I think it will be a bit of a challenge, a big challenge.
And there's Super Sally, a tennis-mad mum who reckons there's a family home in here somewhere.
I would love to be able to get in there. I can even see the potential now.
But there's one person you haven't met yet, the Geelong Gem's owner, Ada Gamble.
Our vendor is just delightful. She's a sweet lady.
When Ada bought the property 26 years ago, the house was in its prime.
I first shifted in, I had the floor shifted in. I had new lino on the kitchen floor and new carpet right through.
Ill health has forced Ada into a nursing home. Selling the house will put her in a better position financially.
Swatch your fingers, Ada.
But she's still a reluctant seller.
I'm very disappointed.
This is your renovator's delight. You know what it is, and you know what it isn't, but also you know what it could be.
There's enough people out there, there's a very big crowd, so...
Good.
It should be an exciting option.
Ada bought the house for $24,000. She finds it hard to believe anyone might want to pay up to $200,000 in today's market.
I don't think we'll get that much, I hope so. But I've got my doubts.
Would someone like to start me off? What do I hear, ladies and gentlemen? Someone like to start me off anywhere? Well, let me put in a vendor bid of $190,000. Yes, 2.5 I have, 190, 2.5 I have. At 190, 2.5 and another 2.5 anywhere. 195 now, at 195. Round me off at 200. I like nice, round, tidy figures. And I've got two now.
There's the big 200. And it only took four bids.
I've got 205. 205,000 now.
Oh, everyone's keen, all right.
205 we have.
Nothing yet from the builders Keith and Brad.
Another 2.5 there.
But there's Super Sally, signing on with a strong first bid.
210 I have. Thank you, 210 now.
We've sailed past the reserve.
212 now. At 212, they're...
Makes you wonder how much further this auction can go.
Ada, we're up to 212 now, so we've passed reserve. Ada, are you happy to sell now?
Oh, yes, thanks. Okay.
In the Blue Mountains, Mark the Mad Hatter is on the home run of his rainwater refit.
Good water strainer, isn't it, eh?
His next job is to drain the water from the old tank into the new one down below.
We have a flow.
We do indeed, and into the new tank it goes.
Well, mate, the power of siphoning water, eh? Sucking out of that tank straight into here, it filled up pretty quick, straight out the overflow, into me bloody tool bag! They called it a submersible pump because that's exactly what you do with it, as long as you've got a rope tied on so you can get it out. Well, the moment of truth. I can hear a noise. Hey, baby, I can see water. I can feel that water.
Not only has the Hatter run his pipe up the drive, he's put in a tap for the garden as well. Too easy.
Inspection time. That should work. Oh, baby, that one's working. Let's get going up the hill. Hey, that's turned on. I can hear it. Oh, beauty. Yep, she's flowing. Righty-o, the middle tank's full. This one's filling up. Now it's going to be curious to see exactly how much pressure is at the end of the line. She'll be right, mate.
Plenty of pressure in the house.
Sweat replacement.
But what about a fire hose? The Hatter wants to make sure he's ready in the event of a bushfire.
One last test. That's the one I really need. It works! I feel rich when my rainwater tanks are full. I actually feel like I'm wealthy and it's mine and I can do what I want with it. And there is no one telling me whether I can restrict it or not. And if I let it run down the hill, you guys get it in Sydney. And I'm going to have it first. You can have it when I'm finished using it. So just let me use it first. Well, this system seems to be working, but if all else fails, I can always go up to the old backup again. It worked.
I takes my hat off to you, Mark. You are truly one of nature's gentlemen.
And I take my hat off to you too, sir.
Boom, boom. And that's all we've got time for. But here's a preview of next week's show.
A little bit by little bit, it's just getting higher and higher and higher.
The Hunshites forced to dig deeper to support their garage habit.
The other day we worked out about $60,000.
That's triple the original budget.
Bloody hell.
It's just money in the end.
A good day in Geelong, 230 and still going.
Buyers slog it out.
43.
244 now.
To put their signature on the Geelong gem.
What's going to go first, the property or my voice?
And taking a sea change in Tassie.
They'd like to give their children a chance at country life. You know.
They're going from this to this. But it won't happen at all.
We don't have time on our side, though. That's
unless the fridge stays with the house.
They come down the extra grand, or the fridge is back up for grabs.
Well, a bloke's got to know if he's got a couple of coldies waiting for him in his new home. Makes perfect sense to me. And it's all ahead of us next time. See you then.